Hi everyone, I'm Trish, and today I'm taking you to lunch at Lupin's. Now, Lupin's is a medium-sized restaurant at Flatiron Square in Union Street with about 5 covers at its downstairs bar counter and another 24 covers upstairs. Lupin's small plates menu features a mix of seasonal changing dishes as well as fixed dishes that are popular with regular customers. Now, small plates is a style of dining that features small portions of food designed for sharing at the table. These are a common sight on London menus, and they suit those who enjoy sampling a variety of different dishes as opposed to a formal 2 or 3 course meal. Our first dish is the cornmeal spring onions with chipotle mayonnaise. Lucy Pedder, who is the co-founder of Lupin's, joins us today to tell us more.
One of the dishes on our menu is the cornmeal spring onions with chipotle mayo. We kind of just loved this from travelling around San Francisco, kind of came across something similar. I mean, spring onions are amazing, like, you know, clues in the name, they're really seasonal right now. And they've just got a lovely flavour. So we kind of just treat them with respect and just put a really light batter, which is literally just milk and polenta. And then we deep fry them, so they just get really, really, like, basically posh onion rings, but they're really good, really Moorish, and the chipotle mayo just, like, cuts through. So, yeah, I think that's kind of, like, quite a good example of one of our kind of key dishes, like super simple, but just using like really great ingredients.
Next, we had the Breen Carpaccio with mint and asparagus. This is an Italian inspired dish with thin slices of raw fish drizzled with herb sauce.
So we get a delivery of fish fresh every day, literally sent up, got in the market that morning. And the Breen is really beautiful at the moment. So we've got a Breen Carpaccio with mint, gremolata and asparagus. Just wanted to really kind of highlight the beauty of the fish and again, keep it really, really simple. So the asparagus is obviously in season now and it's lovely English asparagus. And then we make a mint gremolata, which is essentially just herby, kind of lemon, garlicky dressing that just kind of brings it all alive because it's quite an Italian dressing, but the Breen and the asparagus are both English. So it really sort of comes alive.
We also had the quail with boudin noir, coconut curry sauce and Jersey Royals. I must say that the quail, which is a small game bird with very little fat, took on the Asian spices and coconut cream sauce very well.
So the quail dish is a really beautiful dish. It's with Jersey Royal potatoes, which as well is, you know, obviously really seasonal right now. And quail is a very delicate flavour, so it sort of doesn't like fight with the delicate flavour of the Jersey Royals. And then we just make a really light kind of curry sauce to go with it, just again, you know, using that kind of sunshine influence, just to bring British ingredients and seasonal ingredients to life. So hopefully that's something that you'll find sort of really nice and fresh. And the boudin noir is essentially like a black pudding kind of thing, so it gives it like a nice rich element as well. It's really satisfying, like hearty dish, so it's a very good one.
Last but not least, for our dessert, we shared a baked cardamom yogurt with rhubarb compote. This is a layered pudding with the lightly baked yogurt as the base, a sweet and sour fruit compote in the middle, and a sweet bouncy foam at the top.
We were kind of, I love cardamom, so the baked cardamom yogurt with rhubarb compote was something that we really wanted to get on for a while because I'd been to an Indian restaurant and had a really delicious kulfi dessert. We don't have a freezer here, so we couldn't do that. So we decided to do like a similar to a creme brulee baked yogurt. So it's a little bit lighter and fresher than a creme brulee, not as heavy and rich. And, you know, rhubarb's in season at the moment and it's got that really lovely kind of sour flavour. So we cooked that with orange and ginger and it just sort of cuts through the creaminess of the cardamom, but it's got like a really lovely, gently spiced element to it as well with the cardamom, so it's really good.
Thanks, Lucy. Please click the links below to find out more about Lupin's. Thanks for watching and make sure to subscribe. If you've got a tip for an independent restaurant in London that deserves to be better known, tell us about it in the comment section and we'll try to do a video. Everyone stay awesome and see you later.